better for strength gain and what's good for hypertrophy. A few different studies that I found. The first one we're going to talk about is metadata on the frequency of resistance training. So, and I'll put the links under in the information. So what it talks about for frequency training, according to the meta-analysis, there's not a big difference between training once a week versus three times a week. So unless you're like a high caliber athlete or competitive bodybuilder, or if you're doing something specific for strength training, like just competition wise, then you're probably gonna have to do more research on your own to figure out what's best for you. But in general, it's not necessarily, you don't necessarily get more out of a high frequency training than you do out of a low frequency training. I'm talking about the amount of days of the week that you train. And there's gonna be different factors associated with this. So just personally, like if I were to train once a week for a specific body part, I'm gonna train really hard that day, because I know I don't have any more. But there's also the psychological, hey, if I'm gonna be training more times during the week, I can do less now than more later. And that might be skewing the results a little bit, probably not that much. It's because it's just saying, hey, as long as you're consistently training, then you're going to get results. Like there are slight differences between low frequency training and high frequency training, like in terms of the results. But it's a modest difference. So if you use this information, you can be like, hey, I want to work out more because I want that difference. I want that modest change. Well, then great, right? There is a benefit to training more. But don't let that discourage you, because if you only have time, or you can only, if you're just starting, training once a week is way better than nothing. And it's not like a waste of time. So like I said, it's not the biggest difference. So it's whatever works for you, you're going to get results as long as you are putting effort and you're doing it. It's just if you were to train more frequently, you'd probably get better results, even though it wouldn't be like a significant difference. The second analysis differentiates between people who are very well trained and have experience, or novices or intermediate. You do get results from moderate to high work sets. So effectively it's just saying, hey, if you're working and there's a certain amount of effort into it, then you're gonna get result proportional to that effort. But it doesn't mean that you're gonna get a whole lot more out of a really high effort. You'll probably get a little bit more, but not a whole lot more. So like the study is saying that it's not necessarily quantifiable. And that's gonna be, obviously it's gonna be based on different people and genetics. But as metadata, it's saying that specifically like the low work sets don't do anything. If you're only doing like 5 to 10 minutes of something like a few times a week, you're not gaining anything out of it. You're probably just maintaining just a really low standard of something. But if you spend more time and more effort on it, obviously you're gonna get better results. But it doesn't mean that you have to have the highest work set to get any results, because you're still gonna get it from the moderate work sets. So that's kind of what this is saying. Study that I want to go over isn't meta-analysis. It's just a single study that has, I think, like 8 participants or whatever. So it's not like as good as it could be, right? Also, it's hard to get funding for these. Some of these only go like 8 weeks worth. You're not going to get as much out of it in 8 weeks as you would in 6 months or a year. Right? That's really where you're going to be able to tell the difference between a lot of this stuff. But the 8-week analysis for this, I like this study because they picked one exercise. They picked the leg extensions, so they only focused on one exercise. They did blood tests immediately after, and then they took blood work the next day. So what they were doing is they're measuring protein synthesis over the days after the workout, so they can determine what incurred more protein synthesis, so like what's making the muscles grow. So they compared short, quick repetitions, so like 1 second repetition for the set, and then they compare that to longer repetitions, so like 6 second rep for each of the extensions at like I think 30% of what they could do. So what they determined, and again this is 8 weeks, but what they determined was you get more muscle fiber recruitment out of the longer term exercise. So like a 6 second repetition incurs more muscle fiber recruitment than obviously than the other one, and because more muscle fibers are being used, and you're going to have more muscle synthesis because more of the muscle has been used, right? So my opinion on that is that with your form and like the muscle connection that you're doing, if you have a higher weight and you're just trying to rep it out real fast, you're gonna one, your form might be a little sloppy, but two, you're using inertia. So like once you've started it and you have the momentum, you don't need more muscle fibers because it's already moving and you're taking advantage of that momentum, right? If you have a 6 second time under tension, there is no help from the initial movement, right? That entire sway, like specifically the leg extension, that entire extension has already started. You're using the initial power for that 1 second rep vice, having all your muscle fibers being recruited as necessary to maintain the extension for 6 seconds. So that makes sense to me, right? When you take out inertia and you remove the potential to really mess your form up and kind of cheat when it comes to the exercise, you're going to use more of the muscle fibers. So they're gonna be more muscle synthesis after, more protein synthesis after. So that just like, it tracks with logic when it comes. And then the final analysis is talking about how many sets you do. So 1 set versus 5 sets is I think what they used. And they say that when it comes to certain exercises, they didn't see a big difference. And again, this is only like an 8 week study. So within like 30 or so participants. So they didn't see a big difference between certain exercises. One, because these people have already been experienced in exercising. But two, they specify which one. So like the bench press, they say that they didn't see a big difference in growth or strength in the chest. Well, when you look at it short term, again, 2 months, if you're doing a bench press, even the position of your hands changes, right? It is a much bigger area. So you're not going to overall see a big difference on it. If you take something that's a little more secluded, like the bicep. So like the bicep curl, it's going to be just your bicep. But if you did the bench press and you push here and you're inside, it's going to change which part of the chest really and like how much of the triceps are being used. So because it's more, and I would say because the system is more dynamic when you're doing a bench press versus the others, it's going to take longer to see the specific results that you're looking for. So it tracks that you're not going to see them in an 8 week study. Whereas if you do something specific, like the biceps, you're going to see the results definitively sooner rather than later. Yeah, so like that, again, it makes sense. So to summarize, it doesn't really matter how often you exercise as long as you're putting in the effort when you do it. So do what you can and you're gonna get results. Obviously you get a little bit more from doing more to an extent, but there's that plateau to where it doesn't benefit you to work out 7 days a week versus 5 days a week. I mean, maybe if you're like, again, upper level athlete, and you need that little bit, then sure, go for it. But it's probably not necessary. If you're just trying to go to accrue growth or strength, then just, it's all a lot. You're gonna get more out of the psychological aspect of frequency and consistency and what feels good than you are going to get about the specific information and how often and what percentage you need to do it at, because once you start getting in and kind of parsing all that information to where it's not exciting for you, or it's difficult, or it's not really what you want to do, then the effort that you're going to put into it psychologically is not going to be the same. So really, it's just do all what you can, and you're going to most likely get some benefits from it. Suggested would be at least a couple times a week, around 4 or 5 sets each time you go, and be consistent with it. And also, the time and attention is important, because that's the longer you are using that muscle group, the more muscle fibers you're going to need, so the more growth you're going to see. It's not going to necessarily make it stronger, but you're going to have the hypertrophy that you're looking for. And if you have more volume, then you can later you can switch it over to strength. You can use that. But for hypertrophy, it is really a lot about time under tension and the effort that you're putting during that time under tension. So I'll link these studies. So thanks for watching.